Welcome here to the Exhibition Forum in Hall 3, and thanks again for joining us today. Once more, just as a reminder, you can always watch the videos of the presentation afterwards on our platform Talkie. And our next topic right now is autonomous vehicles, and our speaker is Giuseppe Bonelli from ST Microelectronics.
Thank you. So we expect from autonomous vehicles to be smart. In ST, we have worked making smarter our low voltage MOSFET. So, good afternoon. I'm Giuseppe Bonelli. I'm responsible of technical marketing for automotive low voltage MOSFET for EMEA region. Welcome to this session, and let's start with our approach of system in package. So what we achieved with this approach, we achieved reliability, safety, and performance. Reliability with a small and compact solution, and safety with integrated protection and real-time telemetry. Also performance, using our latest advanced FA technology for low voltage MOSFET. So let's see what we put inside this system in package. So we have the current sensing, the temperature sensing, control and protection. We also have the gate driver and, of course, the power stage that is the DC-DC converter made with our low-voltage MOSFET, FA8, new technology, just released in production last year and the year, optimized for this application for autonomous vehicles. So our system in chip, system in package, sorry, solution is smart because it integrates complex power and signal stage, and also we will see protections and telemetry in a compact automotive package. Is a 5x6 millimeter. Power QFN, fully automotive grade, with a wettable flange, so it's very small. So the third point is attractive in terms of performance and cost. Performance because of its faster switching, higher performance efficiency, lower electromagnetic interference. In terms of cost, because it's an optimized solution, integrated, so if we compare in terms of cost with the discrete solution, this is for sure attractive in terms of cost. But in addition to that, we have also the possibility to reduce the bill of material for the filtering, so reduce the components that generally are used in a discrete solution for filtering to remove all the electromagnetic interference. So let's see also the added features. So we have current temperature sensing for high accuracy monitoring, under voltage and over voltage protection, and the real-time telemetry using a CPU. Now let's move to the power stage, that is a DC-DC converter that consists of an half bridge power stage with two low voltage MOSFET belonging to our latest technology. As said, is the StripFET FA8 technology. We have the both high side and low side. And this technology is fully automotive grade, so qualified according to the AEC-Q101. There is also an optimized design, since the two MOSFET have been designed for this specific system in package solution in order to improve the figure of merit of the MOSFET that, as you know, is the RDS-on per gate charge. Also high performance, so commutation speed at frequencies that up to 1.5 megahertz and low electromagnetic interference. So now let's see our experimental data coming from our application lab. So let's go in details of the system parameters. So our input voltage is 12 volt. Output voltage is 1 volt. Output current max 50 amps. In order to get these results, we have a duty cycle that is around 10%. Switching frequency, that is for the test performed in the application lab inside the window from 600 kilohertz to 2 megahertz. Now to put inductance of 0.15 microhenry. And of course, our power stage with the half bridge, high side and low side StripFET FA8 MOSFET. As I said before, we have two different specifications for high side and low side, as usual. So we have a 4 million MOSFET for the high side with 11 nanocoulomb as gate charge. For the low side, instead, we have 1.2 million at 25 degrees, of course, as a low side. And in this case, since the RDS-on is lower, we have an higher gate charge. But as said, the figure of merit that are the product of the two parameters is optimized for these applications. Now, let's see what we have measured in our application lab, the efficiency. So here you can see the efficiency versus the current of the load at 600 kilohertz, at 1.2 megahertz, and at 2 megahertz. That is the limit that we tested in our application lab. As you can see, at the 600 kilohertz, that is the typical switching frequency in the application, the efficiency is close to 90%. And even at 2 megahertz, we are around 75%. So very good results in terms of efficiency. We have also tested the temperature and current sensing accuracy. So we have on the left the temperature sensing curves. The detected one is coming from the device, and the measured, of course, is coming from the instruments in the lab. On the right side, we have the current sensing curves. Also in this case, we have the detected one from the device and the measured from our application instruments in the lab. So as you can see, the accuracy is very good, and this allow monitoring of the operation of our system in package device. Now let's see one case, is an example, one case of under voltage protection operations. What happens in this case? So we are here in normal operations. So we have the output as a specification, so 12 volt and 50 amps. Now there is the V driver that is decreasing, and this trigger the protection. So the VTMON, that is the voltage signal to the CPU, go down, and also the output in terms of voltage and current is shut down. When the driver voltage come back to the normal value range, the device is able to restart the operation. So we have again the switching and the output voltage as a specification, and also the current that is possible to provide to the load. Now let's see another example of protection that is a key features of this device. In this case, it is a case of over temperature. So we have the normal operation here. There is an increase of temperature that is detected as we have seen previously. So in this case, the voltage signal to the CPU go down, they go up. And protection is triggered. And also in this case, like we have seen before, there is the shutdown of the output in terms of voltage and current. Here we have the details when the VT sense, that is at higher level to highlight this protection mode. So when the temperature come back to the normal range, the VT sense goes to the standard level, and the device is able to restart the operations with the voltage output and the current as per specification. So 12 volt and max 50 amps in the output. Now we can see the measured waveforms for the power MOSFET. In a steady state condition, we have a load of 20 amps and a switching frequency that is the typical in this application of 600 kilohertz. So here we can see a details of the switching of the low side and high side. And here we have the measurements of the V and the T in turn off and turn on conditions. Of course, we have always 20 amps and a switching frequency of 600 kilohertz. So here has been measured the V and the T in a turn off and turn on. So we have 6.9 volt per nanosecond and 7.5 volt nanosecond. That is acceptable, is the right value for this kind of applications. So now let's conclude recapping what we have seen today with our system in package solution. So our system in package solution is smart because integrate complex power stage and signal stage together with added features like protection, current and temperature sensing, and over voltage, under voltage protection, and over current protection. So it's smart. It's compact because as we have seen, we have everything inside in a package that is a tiny automotive grade package, 5 by 6 millimeters. Automotive grade with wettable flange is a classic power QFN, and everything is there. So also the footprint of in the board is limited to 5 by 6. So everything is there. And then, as we have seen, is attractive in terms of performance and cost. Performance because of the faster switching, because of the lower electromagnetic interference, higher power density. And attractive both for performance and for cost, because this solution is for sure optimized in terms of cost when we compare to the standard discrete solution, but it is also attractive because you can reduce the cost of the additional components for filtering that generally are used in the discrete configuration where you have higher electromagnetic interference. So, thank you for your attention. Any question? There is the microphone there. Of course, I invite you to meet us in our booth, Hall 4A, stand 148, where you'll find my colleagues and myself that can answer to all your questions about this kind of product, but also all the other products that ST Microelectronics we have. And believe me, it's a lot of products. Okay, if no questions now, again, visit our stand and you'll find me for any additional question today, okay? Thank you very much for your attention.